Casio Duro is the answer to an often asked question on this channel. What is the best bottom dollar dive watch? I'm flattered that people ask my opinion about this on a number of occasions. And there are a number of interesting options out there that I'm going to discuss in this video in comparison with this Casio. But before I do that, I'm going to describe how this Casio came on the scene in 2011, its specifications, how it stacks up overall in terms of fit and finish and build quality. It'll be a practical review of a very practical watch. In 2011, with very little fanfare, the Casio Duro MDV106 became the successor of the very popular Casio Marlin Diver MDV102. It was a return to a pure design, both aesthetically and mechanically. The Duro unhesitatingly embraces many dive watch archetypes: a stainless steel case, a unidirectional bezel with an aluminum insert, a black dial with applied markers, all very common features to be found in dive watches, and in some ways only uniquely found in this watch because of the level of execution at the given price point. This watch can be found for a measly $35, what often collectors refer to as strap money, and yet we'll see that a recurring theme of this watch is that it really punches above its weight. The prominently featured Marlin on the Duro's dial is a nod to the Marlin Sports dive watch line, which has been part of Casio's line of watches since the early 80s. Interestingly, the name Duro comes from a heavily polluted and depopulated homeworld of the Duro species, located in the Carillion trade spine. Or if you prefer Casio's own explanation, Duro takes its name from the Italian word for durability. At any rate, the current Casio Duro does not have any one specific historical watch reference, although there are a number of interesting features that inherits from other Casio Marlin watches, and I invite you to check out the story of those watches on the Casio Marlin forum. So let's dive right into the details of the Duro. I've got my lovely Caris Customs pen here. You'll notice a wide coin edge bezel, an aluminum insert in the bezel, a fairly tall, I'll see if I can get it to focus here, a loom pip here on the actual bezel insert. Compared to the previous generation Marlin Diver, the Casio is greatly simplified. The seconds track has been reduced from a 1/5 seconds track to a simple 1 second track and has been moved into a chapter ring bordering the edge of the dial. We have applied indices, as you can see, as well as metallic hands, which in my opinion are a little short. We've got a prominent Marlin there. On the back side of the case, we have all the features stated very plainly, and then again the Marlin motif, which appears in very prominent fashion. This is a circular brushed caseback design. We have a number of polished and brushed surfaces, brushed or perhaps satin. Unfortunately, the terms are used somewhat interchangeably, although I think they show different aspects of a non-polished finish. The quartz movement is so unremarkable, I've been able to find almost nothing about it, but that's not really the focus of this watch anyway. One focus is this very nice 120-click bezel, which is certainly held in by a spring in a traditional way, and clicks firmly, yet with the regular amount of play that you would expect from a bezel that has this kind of inherent looseness of tolerance in design. Again, the caseback shows that this watch has a Japanese movement, although the case is sourced from China, and also that it is a solid stainless steel caseback, interestingly with a depth rating of up to 200 meters. Perhaps like the deployment of a folding knife, the crown is the place in a watch where you can really get a sense of the engineering excellence or tightness of tolerances. And unfortunately, in this watch, you really get a sense that they essentially went for the minimum that they could at this price range. There's not a lot of play, it doesn't feel like it's going to break or anything, but it's simply unremarkable. The crown unthreads from the base of the case simply and unassumedly, and probably in a very effective way based on the Amazon reviews I've read of people who have dived with this watch. I am not a diver. Yet nevertheless, as you cycle through the dates, which it takes a full 360-degree rotation of the crown to get from one day to the next, you're left with the impression that this watch is still very much a budget watch, and the quartz movement is perhaps the thing that is holding this watch back the most. It appears the dial is brushed in a sunburst pattern and then coated, and it is very beautiful in detail. Unfortunately, the fact of a mineral crystal means that I've already acquired a scratch in it underneath the date aperture. On the wrist, I would say the watch wears small because it's very thin, compared to the Seiko SKX-009, which is a full millimeter smaller overall. The watch actually wears overall in, I would say, a smaller way. It does sit flatter on the wrist and covers a larger footprint, as it were, but the greatly diminished height, a full millimeter, is noticeable on the wrist, and of course, being a quartz, it's very lightweight. The lume on the dial, although applied to all of the important hands and indices, is nevertheless fairly unremarkable compared to its Seiko counterparts. In terms of alternatives, there are tons, and I mean literally tons, of other MDV watches in the Casio line, so someone interested in this watch, or in general liking the idea of a quartz Casio in a analog timepiece, might have good luck exploring different options within the line. Of course, if you wanted to pay a little bit more money and get an automatic movement, there's Seiko. Another often forgotten option is Orient. And perhaps a most interesting option would be going with a Russian watch, an Amphibian. In the end, the good things about this watch greatly outweigh the negatives. It has incredible bang for buck, making an excellent, timeless, simple statement in its design. It has the reliability of a Casio, and probably the engineering built into it so that you could die with it. As far as the minuses being the smaller crown, the use of a mineral crystal, and a quartz movement, these are all things that perhaps Casio could remedy by having an automatic movement, which in my mind would double or triple the value of this watch. Overall, I've enjoyed this watch, and it's a solid backup for a more serious collector or a faithful and dutiful diver for someone looking for a low cost of entry. Make sure to comment below if you have any experience with the Casio Duro, or if you have any opinion about what dive watch is the best at this price point. Or is it worthwhile to save a little money and buy an automatic watch? Make sure to check out these other videos if you have a chance, and thank you very much for watching.